When I think of fate's worse than death, all I can think of is something you said.
Yeah. It sucks when shitty people get the upper hand.
Oh, he does not have the upper hand.
Well, I'm not saying upper hand. I just mean have a hand.
It's when they pull the rug out from under.
Right.
Hand either.
Right.
Yeah. All he did was fuck us over.
Yeah. Well, that does not give him
an upper hand.
Okay.
It gives him the ability to fuck us over for a little bit.
Gives you the ability to fuck people
but
over.
But little does he know that he's incredibly replaceable. Mm. We already have a replacement.
Welcome to the William Barron Show. Hashtag Ask Bradley. Mm-hmm. We are without our fourth tonight, Craig Ketchum. We miss you. We hope you're
laughing at somebody else tonight, Craig.
We wish you safe passage through the city.
I like that you have his mic still set up.
Yeah.
He's here.
You notice it's not plugged in, though.
It's just an empty tall mic waiting for his tall ass.
It's like he's died or something.
Poor little elf, my homie.
Put some flowers down every week.
We'll never replace you, pal.
Never ever.
But your mic will always stand. Stand tall.
It is standing tall.
It is very erect.
It is. Just get like an Olympic torch and replace the microphone with it so it like constantly
just
burns.
Close.
Craig would have liked it this way.
Yeah. Yes,
he would have.
He really would. We might need to take a photo.
Welcome to the William Barron Show. As always, I am joined by Danielle. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
And Joseph.
Hello.
I see that you're drinking a cold beer.
Ice cold. On an ice cold night. Mm-hmm.
Here's a koozie to keep that beer colder.
My hand was so cold, it was making my beer warm. Yeah.
Where's mine?
Oh, well, you got a plastic cup. That
doesn't
really
matter. Oh, it's still cold.
We got a Black Balloon Studio koozie. It says Black Balloon Studio. Follow us on Facebook. Boom. iTunes.
The
winning bam.
Game. Bam.
Look on the bottom.
Yeah, whenever you're drinking.
Black Balloon. Yep. Oh, in your face. I like that idea. I've never seen that before. The bottom imprint.
These were, I've never seen that either. I've never seen like a koozie with something on the bottom.
You can't not look at it.
Wow. It's
fucking unbelievable.
Try not looking at my bottom.
And now take a drink.
Well, these wonderful koozies, we got a couple other ones that I'd like to bring out because I think you would probably want a couple of them. But they're made by our friends Exkooz Yourself Koozies. Find them on Facebook. Find them on our
how do you
Facebook
spell that?
Page.
It's always confusing.
Exkooz.
Exkooz.
Exkooz Yourself.
Exkooz Yourself.
Exkooz Yourself Koozies.
Mm-hmm.
Does
love them.
Good work, right?
Amazing work.
Yeah.
It's so legit looking, I can't even get over it.
It's
a fucking great koozie.
It's a koozie.
It's a great fucking koozie.
I look
koozie.
At it. All right, so wait a minute. I'm looking at the printing technique.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I'm in that world, right?
Right.
Yeah. Please.
How do they print these? Do you know?
Screen print, I believe.
This is a screen print? You can't even feel it. Because most times on the screen print, it's like you can almost...
The ribs.
Peel it off?
You could peel it off, but you could pick at it.
He actually mentioned that he uses technology that you can wash them, they won't peel, they won't do anything.
Can you wash them?
You can wash them.
Mm.
Wash them.
Sorry.
You could wash them, but I'd wash it.
I say wash. Fuck off.
So here are a couple of other ones that he sent us, just as complimentary. He likes doing this for the...
what I'm looking at is a green koozie with a picture of Yoda.
Mm.
And it says... lie, I cannot. Big butt. I can't. I can't do Yoda. I can't do Yoda.
Oh, your first part was great.
Lie, I cannot. Big butt, like. That's not Yoda. That is not Yoda. That's terrible.
It was good.
All right.
I laughed.
I've never seen anything like this. It says trek yourself before you wreck yourself.
We got a cartoon drawing of Spock
doing the
West Side.
No, it's
well, he's doing the Vulcan,
Klingon or Vulcan.
He's doing the Vulcan pinch thing.
Oh, you can do it?
But it's like the
Oh, you can do it too?
You can't do that?
Fuck no, I can't. My pinky and my ring finger do not go together. Ever.
All right.
Can't make
that's
heaven.
Good. Trek yourself before you
wreck yourself.
I think Craig, I'm going to want that one.
There's this one. This one, I'm having a hard time understanding what the Goonies has to do with
Well, this Superman. Is, did Sloth wear the Superman shirt? In the Goonies, didn't Sloth like pull his shirt open and go, "Hey, you guys!" And he hits the spinners on over a Superman shirt.
All right, so they're Sloth approved.
Yeah.
And I get it. The suspenders are on the side.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what
okay.
That is.
There you go.
Yes, sir.
And then my personal favorite is if you remember Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Of course I do.
Thug Life.
We've got this almost looks like a in memory of
right.
Thug Life. Yeah. Never forget. And it's got a picture of
Carlton.
Should be
Carlton.
Tupac,
Carlton.
But it's Carlton
in his bow tie with that Carlton smirk
smile.
On his face,
stupid grin,
mustache.
Love
it's
it.
This Thug
Love
Life.
It. We also did get some Bears ones.
Yeah, but
two Bears ones.
Yep. Yep.
But we haven't given them to my pops.
Well, you haven't given both of them, have you?
No, I haven't given
just
them
the
any
one?
Yet.
Well, you can have the other Bears one. The other one, it actually looks kind of cool. It's like
super
a...
super cool. Vintage style.
Ditka glasses over a Bears logo.
I'll tell you guys, this is cool.
And then on the bottom,
yeah,
again,
so
it says, the Bears.
The Bears.
I'm telling you, these are stand-up, straight-up koozies.
They're great.
You should buy these.
They're great. Everybody should buy them.
Go to Exkooz Yourself Koozies. You can find them on our webpage, blackballoonstudio.com. Either way, welcome back to the podcast. Joe, what the hell did you do last week? We were too busy being in Mexico.
I know. You guys were gone. I
fucking warmth.
What did I do with my break? You mean?
Yeah.
From the podcast?
Your week off.
Well, I did a spinoff podcast is what I did.
You did?
No, you did not.
I'm sure you guys, I'm sure the listeners.
Oh, what a great fucking day for him to abandon us.
Oh, Joey, don't do it.
No. I thought, hey, gang's gone. The boss is out of the business. Why don't I fire up the old microphones?
Uh-huh.
See what's happening.
Did you really?
I went,
you're
a little man on the street. I walked up and down the streets of Peoria.
In 12 degrees.
Did you really make a podcast?
Fuck no, I didn't do any podcasts.
As soon as he said he
I was about
outside,
to cue it up.
Liar.
I wanted to
you
cue it up and
go
listen to it.
Fuck outside. And talk to
that
would
have been a great
cold outside.
If I put any pre-production work into the show, that would have been it. That would have been great.
That would have been your bit for the first segment?
Yep.
They stand themselves
well, up. Well, careful now.
Yeah.
One thing about these koozies is you don't have a solid... You got to hold a koozie.
Yeah.
You don't want to set a
always.
Koozie down.
No.
Although,
what?
You're having a party, right?
Mm-hmm.
No, you know, everyone's going to think we're doing this, like, hour-long commercial for Exkooz Me.
Exkooz Yourself Koozies.
Well, we just got them. They're dope.
But the one thing I love about the koozie is, okay, obviously, keeps cold drink, keeps your hand warm.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
But let's say you're having a party, and maybe your wife or you or...
You're thinking coasters.
I'm thinking... You can't trust these assholes to use coasters.
Nope.
Hey, let me put a koozie on that.
Mm-hmm.
Boom. Instant
coaster.
No matter where they put their drink.
Mm-hmm. 100% agreed.
Yeah. Oh, my great-grandfather's grandfather clock. Oh, my God, no.
It got water stains.
Hey, easy. Exkooz yourself.
I have a koozie. Bada bing, bada boom.
I feel like we could run their YouTube ad.
That's a commercial right there.
We got their YouTube marketing campaign right now. Exkooz yourself.
Yep.
That was great. That was great.
Excuse yourself. Put a coaster on that.
Or a koozie.
Or a koozie. Boom.
Boom.
Boom. Got
done.
It.
Both.
Trek yourself.
One. Trek yourself.
Be at Black Balloon on the bottom.
So, while we were...
okay, so I was here freezing my ass off is what I did while you were gone. And what did you do?
I mean, it was a lot of 80-degree weather.
Yes.
Beaches that weren't too... safe.
I did step on a shard of glass and get
where were you?
It in my foot.
Rio de Janeiro?
That's not. Riviera Maya.
Is that in Brazil?
Close.
I think I believe we've been
close.
Over this.
I go to
close.
Rio
de Janeiro.
Where did we go? What was the name of the city?
Riviera Maya.
Riviera Maya. That wasn't safe. I had my honeymoon there.
It was safe.
Was it really?
That's where I went.
You seriously went to there?
I think.
Nice.
Okay.
Just wait. South of Cancun.
I don't know.
There was
like
like an hour south of Cancun.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. 45 minutes.
Yeah.
No, it was like you. I walked out to the beach the first day that we got there. Like we unloaded all of our shit and then we all got into our fucking. This is after a day of travel.
Do you remember
so,
the resort you were at?
Sandos.
Susie.
That's
Davis travel.
That's sketchy.
Guaranteed.
No, the resort was not sketchy. Our beach wasn't that great. It just really wasn't.
Well, that area is on a gulf. or it's on the like lagoon.
Yes.
So you don't have a beach. You
no,
have
rocks.
You have a view of ocean, but there's no beach.
You can't get in the water.
Yeah.
The beach was okay, but the water, you couldn't get in the water because there was too many rocks and shells and curry.
Yeah.
Well, no. That doesn't even worry me. When I walked down on the beach for the first time on the fucking, there was a, it looked like beached whales
yes,
all
did.
The way down.
He's like, oh my God, there's a fucking
and
beach
they
whale?
Move. Like it,
they
it's like
move.
They do. I looked at one move. Like I don't mean like move, like roll over. I just
they
mean
move
like
Whoa!
Yeah. It was like
no, it was, did not move.
It looked like a beach whale, but like any time like the wave would come in, you could see like a little flap of it because it was like. I don't know if it was minerals or if it was reef or
the water coming over
coral.
Going, oh, that feels so good. Shudder. Oh.
But I saw a flap. I found a flap on one of those whales that moved every time.
It wasn't a whale. There was no whales.
I know it wasn't, but I wasn't going to go out there and touch it.
On that ocean.
She dared me to go out and touch it. And I was like, fuck no, I'm
a
not touching
whale?
It. Whatever
it
the
was
fuck
not
that
a
is.
Fucking whale.
Whatever it is, it doesn't matter.
It was like a giant
I wasn't gonna
reef. With shit growing on top of it, which, yes,
above water.
I can avouch. Well, no, I
mean, it looked like
when a wave
somebody's
would come over
liver.
It, the wave would be over it. But then when it would go back out, it would be a little shallower, obviously. That's the way the fucking ocean tides work. It was not a goddamn whale.
Sounds
I'm
like this giant
that
reef
was,
a, was giving you
was
some
giant
grief.
That's a koozie right there.
You're so stupid.
But what I'm saying is, like, these giant reefs... They were like every 20 to 30 feet.
Yeah, they were.
I mean, they were everywhere. And
you had to walk like a mile to not find
them. I didn't feel safe with my kids.
But I'm not
bitching
about
them.
It. It was still 80 degrees and we were in our swimming suits.
Well, I got a spa story for you. Have you ever had a massage, a professional massage?
Oh, no.
Should
I want
break
one
first?
So bad.
Oh.
I went on get hot and I live on get stained. When we saddle up and ride on in the pouring rain. When a junkyard dog with a alley cat. Keep the wind at the front and the hell at the back. That's who we are. With you I'm talking, walk that walk. Wide open rockin', that's how we roll. Back to the wall, a band of brothers.
A lot of hobbies. I told you that.
He's dude,
a hobbyist.
He dissed you so bad.
A hobbyist? What is a hobbyist?
Because he's a real musician. He's doing something real. And this is your fucking hobby.
Oh.
You're not even a fucking real
musician. Oh, shit. I'm not on his level.
Right.
I'm a hobbyist.
Yep.
Okay. Gotcha.
Thanks
duly noted.
That much worse.
Sorry.
No. It makes
nice
perfect sense.
Up. Yep, it does.
It makes perfect sense. Welcome back to the William Barron Show. Danielle, thank you for being here again.
Mm-hmm.
Joseph?
I'm so glad. I'm glad to be back, you know. I got off of work today, and I was like, man, I can't wait to get drunk. I mean, I can't wait to come talk
well,
to my
what
friends.
What the hell are we using these koozies for if it's not to get drunk?
Holla.
What are you talking about? I'll use this on like a Coke.
Bottle of water.
Yeah,
I'll put mine around a fucking bottle of water every day.
I used it on
a
7-Up, a diet 7-Up
sure.
the other
Watch
day.
Watch me. I'll do it at work.
Zero calories.
Bring my bitch in my purse and wear it at work.
Craig Ketchum, we miss you.
I'm a solicitor.
Hope you're
at work.
Enjoying the show. This segment brought to you by Exkooz Yourself Koozies. We were talking before the break. You've never had a massage.
No, I've never had a professional.
Yeah,
professional.
I mean, I'm not talking like a back row.
I never paid for
a
massage.
Okay.
The closest I ever got was someone I worked with was a massage therapist on moonlighting, or they weren't going to school. I don't, you know, they get,
right.
I don't know,
like
they get certified or something.
Having, yeah.
I don't know what they do. So she actually gave me like a shoulder massage that lasted like 2 minutes, and it was the most painful, excruciating pain of my life. But as soon as she let go,
you were like, no, don't stop.
Everything like, it felt so great. Mm-hmm. Like, the whole time she's on, I'm like, oh, stop. No, no, I hate this. I hate. She's like, just relax, relax. I'm like, no, quit it. No, you're hurting me. Oh, just relax. And when it was all done with, I was like, oh, my God. Mm-hmm. I never felt so loose in my flesh. Yeah. It was great. So, and ever since, you know, my wife will go out and get pedicures, manicures, all that shit.
Right, right.
And, you know, they massage your legs and stuff while they do that.
Right.
Which I'm not opposed to that. I want to go get my toenails cut.
Yeah, right.
Go.
I kind of want to go and just be like,
men
hey,
do
cut
do
my
it.
Toenails.
Fix
men
my
do,
shit.
Men do that. They do. Scrape my feet. Shave them down.
And I want to be one of those
That's
men.
That's disgusting.
Do it.
I don't want to be
Here's
one of
Here's the problem.
Men.
I don't want to do it.
Alone.
Alone.
And I, no, go with your wife. Oh, stop. Does she, what does are she you always gonna... go with a girlfriend?
She
doesn't. She can go by herself.
But.
Does she go by herself?
We've never, she's never brought it up, like, or maybe, she, I don't know. She's never put the effort in to say, let's go do this.
Because she'd be like, you're not going to want to do it. I know you're
No,
not
I want to do it.
Wow.
Fucking go.
I've asked every guy friend of mine to say, hey, how do you feel about pedicures? Well, that's stupid, man. I would never do that.
Yeah,
like,
fuck it.
Oh, really?
Have you asked Bill?
I think so, too.
Because it was, I mean, Bill was the one who was like, let's do this massage.
I've asked Bill. And it, trust me, I've what, seen him in sandals. He could use
ago,
it.
Yeah. He's got, your toenails are.
They grow fast and furious. I can't, I can't help
you
it.
You could probably kill somebody with your big toenail.
I could.
I'm not kidding.
I no. literally could if I let it go long enough.
You're like a car in the Fast and Furious.
I am. Driven by Paul Walker. No, I'm sorry. He wasn't driving. My bad.
Yeah, he was, wasn't he?
No, he was the passenger.
No.
Yeah,
he was driving.
No, he wasn't. Some NASCAR guy was driving. He was friends with the NASCAR guy. NASCAR guy got a little too
drunk,
footy with the pedal. Paul Walker perishes, and NASCAR guy's. I think he got out of the hospital like a month ago.
But wait, he lived?
Yeah. Yeah.
How do I guy, not know this?
I don't know. Pay attention
I don't know
to Facebook.
Anyway, you were talking about massages before I so crashed this podcast.
So we decide, she's like, I hooked you up for a massage. And I was like, I don't really want to go to a massage.
Like a couple's massage? Or
yeah.
Just like,
yeah.
I had originally signed us up to do it. Mom said she'd watch the children's for us, whatever.
Is this like you go lie in a hut on the beach? The
no,
wind's
that,
blowing
that
in.
Bitch was like $300. Yeah. No, I signed us up to the one in the spa that was like $70.
But okay. I mean, it's still a spa.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean,
yeah,
so.
It's still super nice.
So she comes over to me, and this is after I've watched like all four kids or whatever, and I'm just fucking outside of my mind. She hands me a card and she says, hey, what would you like to do off of this card? And I'm like sitting there, like pedicures, you know, manicures. I'm sitting there being like, facial wash? What the fuck is a facial wash? That's got to be amazing.
Is it in alphabetical order?
For $60 to have somebody wash your face. Like, your face has to feel like brand new for like a month.
Yeah. So you're reading the list and you're like,
I could do facials, blah, blah, blah.
And then you get to manicure, and you're like,
I'm
whoa,
like,
whoa,
all
whoa,
right.
Where's H? Where's the H? Where's the happy ending?
I don't know.
Do not see that on the list.
So I decide
he zips down to S.
Yeah.
So
stone massage.
So, well, I keep seeing all these commercials.
Oh, you're in Mexico. You're thinking stoned massage.
Stone.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, buddy.
I think you misread that, bud.
No, I am a complete victim to marketing on spas because they always show the girl like laying down with a couple of hot rocks on her back.
On her spine.
Or on her spine, yeah.
Yeah, being
and
all
it's
sexy
like,
with a sexy
It's like,
doing
holy
her
shit,
and
I want to know why there are rocks on
why
her
is
back.
Is that so great?
Yeah.
What is so awesome about this? So I'm like, I want to do the rock spa. And she's like, okay. We'll do the rock spa.
Rock spa.
Rock spa. That's what we did. The
so
rock spa.
I had been
oh,
at
both
a,
of you did it.
Yeah, we did it together.
We both did it together.
You,
Same
so
room.
Wait a minute. Have you ever had a massage?
Oh, yeah.
Well, then why did you go along with the rock spa?
I have never done that.
Okay.
She's like,
I'll
whatever
try
you
anything
pick.
Once.
All right, so you want to
try
it.
Anything once.
Yeah.
It's fucking weird. I'll never do it again.
What are they doing?
So we walk up. They give us keys.
I had a stone shoved in my ass crack. For starters.
What do you mean shoved in there?
I'm talking like, here's my ass crack.
Did she spread here's the ass?
Yes.
No, she just slid the rock.
Yeah, no, she didn't actually take my ass cheeks and spread them, but she slid the rock
she
down my
ass crack.
She
didn't spread them to set it in and then let your ass cheeks close?
No, she slid it into
so
my ass crack.
So she pushed it into the
crack? Yes.
Like
yes,
an,
she did.
Like an ATM card.
Yep.
To get
on
it?
Its side. Like it's a soft,
flat stone. Yeah.
I would imagine. I didn't see it. Obviously, I was on my back.
Well, you hope it's pretty if it's up your ass.
I mean, whatever. It could be ugly. I wouldn't care.
Oh my!
But covered it was in that weird
algae
it was
stuff
weird.
From the ocean.
It was odd. I was like, whoa, ho, huh?
Now, what was the purpose? Like, was she trying to work it towards your anus?
No, it never went in my anus. It just stayed there.
Oh my!
For like 30 minutes.
Okay. So it's just a. It's just a little
to walk you
it's not
through
little,
this
no,
entire
no,
process.
No, Joe, it's not little. I mean, I'm talking. It's a stone this big.
Did they do this to you?
I never got any ass crack motion.
So they only do it
to the ladies,
or the lady you got was like, "I got an extra stone." Her like
shoving her asshole.
Because your back wasn't as long as, as they expected.
I'm a petite girl.
She's
I'll
like,
admit it, yeah.
I'll just put this last one right here.
No, that was the first
and I
one.
Bet she was like,
it was the first one. It was the first fucking one for me. It was the first stone I had ever experienced anywhere, and it was in my asshole. I'm like, oh my God.
And I bet while we're laying face down
in
these chairs, she's going
does
like,
does Bill have a fucking stone in his asshole right now? Because he's probably freaking the fuck out if he does. Then I'm like, it's fine because it was his idea.
He signed us up for the bone.
All right, so we got way ahead of ourselves on this story.
Sorry.
But,
I cannot get over the ass crack stone. I just can't do it.
All right, so we changed our massage to a stone bath, and whatever, and they gave us keys immediately. Like somebody escorted us back to the locker room and was like, "You take all your clothes off, leave your
lock it up,
leave your pants on, blah blah blah, leave your underwear on,
leave your undergarments on." Okay, well we weren't planning on doing it right away.
I've been out of underwear for like 3 days.
Bill brought
free
three pairs of underwear to an all-inclusive resort
because I expected there to be a laundry service. An affordable.
Well, there probably is one. It just
there
costs
is.
You.
It's just $50.
Very expensive. So we brought three pairs of drawers to wear. So he was freeballing it
for like 3 days straight.
Hang
and I'm like, I can't.
When you're packing and you're trying to pack light,
yeah,
underwear is the one you go. Well, that's too much.
No, dude, I
two
wore
two more pairs. I can't do it.
I wore like the same shirt. You got to understand, packing in the same suitcase with this woman.
Yeah,
like she, it's like Tetris. And you're trying to fit an L in a square shape.
Ladies and gentlemen, I do not have light.
It's
don't.
Like
really
shoes in horribleness, and I get left like this little tiny area.
That's
and I got to fit
fair.
My jeans.
I completely admit it. But you can't go over
socks,
the 50 pound mark, so we're packing this bitch in like
and
a
you're
fucking
using 48 pounds of them.
I'm using like we have like carry ons that we're checking, so it's not over the 50 pound
right.
fucking limit because I ain't paying the extra. I ain't doing it. I'm a cheap ass. It ain't happening. So we're I'm packing.
But you'll pay $70 to have a stone shoved up your ass.
I wouldn't have paid that. That was his idea. So yes. Right,
keep blaming me for the luxurious stone up your ass.
I mean, it was.
Keep it up.
It was not bad.
Yeah, okay.
It wasn't
maybe
bad.
That's why you didn't get
like,
one,
I didn't
Bill.
Hate it.
She pulled your underwear down. And said, whoa, this guy hasn't changed in a while.
His ass is way too tight. Yeah.
All right,
I'm
so
nothing down there.
I'm not watching this stone.
Funky ass.
Funky ass motherfucker. I haven't even dipped in the fucking pool yet. I was
we
like,
hadn't even showered. Like,
uncleansed.
Neither one of us had showered since the day before.
Ever.
So wait a minute, you guys.
We were not planning on doing it.
You guys
right
walk
away.
Up to the counter, you're like, yeah, we'd like to order a
book
massage.
Appointment.
And they're
for like tomorrow.
Sure, here's your key.
Let's go.
Go. In the back.
Get it now.
So okay, as we're going into the gym.
Like, I haven't even shaved. Like, I'm so self-conscious about that.
As we're going into the locker room, she's like, take everything off but your underwear. And I was like, well, that's going to be hard for me because I don't have underwear.
Yeah.
On?
On.
No.
So, like, I put on the
they were dirty,
the
so
robe.
He was just freeballing it.
I was just freeballing it for, like, 3 days.
Are you sure?
I was conserving underwear at this point.
That's disgusting.
He did that.
Every morning, you bet, I woke up and I was like,
Joe, it was like $10 to wash a pair of underwear. $10 to wash a pair of underwear.
You realize you can go to the sink?
I tried. They don't sell detergent at the fucking
hand
store.
Hand soap. Water, wash your drawers,
air dry.
Hang them on the counter.
All right.
All right.
Clean. All right. All right. Well, it must have left me. So they gave us the keys to the locker. I put on the robe and the little stupid shoes, and I go back out to the fucking thing, and I'm just like, are you wearing anything? And she's like, no. They told us to wear our
undergarments. So you got a massage in your jeans or?
No, I did. I got naked.
Yeah.
Like naked. She's naked.
I was
and
naked
we're like,
too.
They told us that we need
I
underwear.
I didn't have undergarments on either.
Oh, you went naked too?
I didn't.
She doesn't ever wear undergarments.
Why bother?
I'm
ever.
Not a fan of undergarments. I'm just not.
So we're both.
Me. I just occasionally I wear a bra, but not.
We're both sitting naked. In the little waiting room listening naked. To the fucking ocean and the naked? Birds and stuff. Not naked, but in our robes.
Oh, yeah, in our slippers.
In our sandals
yeah,
robes.
Yeah, no, we're not just sitting there like...
Sitting in the waiting room.
Naked.
Yeah, we'd like to order a couple... Head. I'll have what they're having.
And Danielle is like... You, they told you that we have 30 minutes. And I was like, well, I get... What do you think? And she's like, well, you can go back to our room and get us clothes.
Or swimsuits, something. Yeah.
So I went back. I ran all the way back to the room, come all the way back. We changed into our underwear. Into our
fucking swimming suits
they
on.
They forced you to have clothes on?
No. Yeah. They didn't
well,
force
that's
it,
what they told
but
us.
They instructed us to wear our undergarments.
To leave our undergarments
we didn't have,
on.
So.
But then they put a stone up your ass.
Yeah, so then we get in the goddamn room and bitches.
Whoa, hold on.
First thing she wants to do is pull your pants down.
Hold on. So these two women who look like they've each had a litter of children come out.
They're like 45.
William, Guatemalan.
Yeah. Middle-aged Mexican women.
They were both very nice and both
nice,
beautiful older women. But
beautiful?
You could,
really? Oh,
I'm
yeah.
sure they were.
No.
So as we're walking back there, she's like, I'm so
they're
happy
not
that
they're... They are not what Bill expected.
I wasn't expecting it. I was expecting exactly what I got.
You were expecting the hot girl...
I was not, no.
No, you were expecting the hot girl with the stones on her back to stand up... And do your massage.
Right.
No. That's what
I was expecting
for.
A man.
Like
I'm not going
like
to lie.
An alien or
I'll
something?
Be completely honest. I was totally expecting a dude to do mine and a chick
really?
To do yours. And I expected both of them to be attractive.
No.
I did. Ooh,
they're going to both be women.
It was expensive.
Why is it attractive? Our face is face down in a fucking
not
pillow.
The whole time.
All right. Well, we will talk about the flip side.
We got
coming
over.
Up after
was,
this one.
It was something.
Thank you for listening to the William Barron Show.
Talk to me softly. Something in your eyes. Don't hang your head in sorrow, and please don't cry. I know how you feel inside. I've been there before. Something's changing inside you, and don't you know? Don't you cry.
All right, so I go back to the room in our my shorts and her two piece bathing suit.
Mm-hmm. It's getting hot.
Senorita and Senora and Senora both come out. They were not senoritas.
Nope.
They both grab us.
Hola.
Hola, William.
As they walk us back.
Hola,
Danielle?
William.
They walk us back, and as soon as we get in, it's all dim lit. It's warm. It's nice music and
sexy.
Stuff. And they're like, take off everything. And we're like, wait a minute, wait. Are you sure?
We were just told that we had to have clothes on. What the fuck?
No.
I was like, but you want, me like, you want me to leave my bottoms on, right? And she was
no,
like,
we want
no.
you naked.
No.
No. No. No.
No.
Naked.
No, naked.
Every single
naked.
One.
Yes.
Every single one.
See.
Si. Like.
So
okay.
we do.
What about the boner factor in this?
It's
I'm
coming.
Getting to that.
It's coming.
Oh, my.
So while she's having her ass crack fondled with a hot rock.
Yeah, I did.
I'm laying on my stomach,
yeah,
and this girl is like rubbing lotion all over me, and I know.
Oh, it's wet.
Yeah, it's yeah, it's all
warm oil. It's
well,
not
that
lotion.
Makes
it's
it even
warm
more
oil.
Like, that makes it more sensuous,
warm,
right?
Warm, moisty oil.
Well, not only that, they hold their hands in front of you, like
smell
to breathe
shit?
In their
like you get,
it was like eucalyptus.
Oh, they just want you.
What was
they
that?
Want you to breathe.
Yeah,
it.
Yeah
never,
they want you. They said
we never talked
deeply.
About this. We never talked about
breathe
that.
Deeply.
What the fuck was that?
Yeah.
Did you kind of get a little high from it?
I didn't get high from it. No, it smelled like
maybe
eucalyptus.
Maybe it was my brain, but I felt like I got a little high from it.
Eucalyptus, but
I don't know. It was early,
all right.
And I felt high.
Yeah,
I mean, you were probably just a little hungover.
Yeah,
this is
before.
Great.
Maybe you had a light breakfast.
That's well, so I had every morning for breakfast. I had like 5 mimosas.
Mm. Okay, so you were drunk, not
I.
But
drunk, pretending I was high.
So this girl is massaging me on my back, putting rocks in every place other than my ass crack.
I can't believe you didn't get one in your fucking ass.
They
crack.
Even put
it makes
one.
Me kinda mad.
They even put one on the bottom of your foot and wrapped
yeah,
a towel around
that was
it.
Great.
So that your whole foot just like melted into the rock.
See, I'm surprised for the guy they don't kind of spread the leg and tuck one up by the balls.
Well, maybe
right up in there.
Ah, ooh,
yeah.
Ee.
That's apparently part of the trick part, too.
Once that's over.
And that makes you a little sterile for the rest of the holiday weekend.
Yeah. There you go. It does. Yeah, burn off those sperm. Mm-hmm. So so then after they were done, like, with your back, like, I thought that was it. All right, thank you. I appreciate it. Hola, gracias. They're like, no, flip over. And I was like,
yeah,
okay.
I thought we were done, too.
So now we're doing the same thing that they just did to my front. And I had hit the gym every day that week.
Because you're preparing for the beach.
Well, I was just, I don't have anything to do here. This place is boring, so I'm going to go to the gym and actually do something, you know, for an hour a day, mm-hmm. run a couple miles and lift some weights, and I felt great.
Yeah.
Felt great. I felt I looked great. So as soon as she gets to my stomach, my core, which I had been working on all week.
You're feeling good.
All 3 to 4 days.
You're confident.
Like, and this is where,
and
like.
And you've not been eating, so you felt
And
like
I haven't been eating,
great.
So I'm, like, skinny because Mexican food at resorts sucks balls, apparently. So I don't know. I can't speak specifically if it was like her rubbing oil on my stomach, and I thought, oh yeah, I fucking feel that shit.
She's
yeah.
going down. Oh,
I, no, like I was, I impressed myself with my own image or whatever.
So you feel like you are in your like mentally.
I'm like
you're
Brad,
impressed.
Yeah.
You're impressed by yourself, and you're also confident. So you're also feeling like. This Mexican lady has
is
touched the stomach like
no.
This.
We saw a couple of the guys in the weight room.
Weeks.
Ever.
This body Ever. Is making her. And then all of a sudden the dick started moving. I was like, whoa. No. No. Stop. And she kept
I
rolling down.
The towel is there?
No, yeah, it was a bed sheet.
Oh,
and she keeps rolling it down. She keeps rolling it down to like my solar
she
plexus.
She gets the pube?
Well, I take care of myself, so no. But like she gets, like she That's, rolls.
She goes too far. She's waiting for the pubes. Pubes now. Where are the pubes?
No pubes.
No pubes. Oh my. Oh.
Penis. Oh no.
Oh, William. Oh.
Well, like
hola.
Hasta mañana. But
see you tomorrow.
By like the third, by the third roll, I knew that she was in boner land. So if I had a if I got a boner right now, I know it's gonna be like sticking his little fucking head out the top.
You gotta imagine she sees boners all the
and
time.
And I'm like,
though,
I'm
right?
like, but I know, but I don't want to be that guy.
You don't
so
want
like,
her to see your. Boner.
I'm like, you're not getting a boner. You're not getting a boner. Get over that whole fucking you think you look hot shit.
I saw.
Get over
boner.
That 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
I saw your boner.
No, you didn't.
Yeah,
stop.
Didn't. Yeah, I did.
So
did you get a full-on boner?
Full
Yes, he did.
On.
I saw it.
Full-on.
Because I was peeking at him. He apparently didn't peek at me at all. And see, my...
No, he was too busy getting a boner.
Well, see, but I'm sitting...
Too busy trying to not get a boner.
Listen,
right.
So, but I'm laying there...
No.
Listen, though. As naked as he is, I was, too.
Yeah.
Like...
Oh, so they roll
they
you
covering
over...
covering up your boobs.
But you're topless. Because yeah. you're a couple, it doesn't matter.
No.
Right. And she's a woman massaging her. I'm right. sure if it was a guy
so,
that he would probably put something over
something,
your...
So you
yeah.
don't want a guy.
She got slightly turned on by a middle-aged Mexican woman.
You got it, too.
I did.
It was the eucalyptus.
I don't know what it was. I was drunk and high.
It was Viagra in lotion form.
No, it was how she touched...
Yeah. yeah. She yeah. rubbed it just right.
Yeah. But they went, like, all the way up your leg. Like...
Yeah.
She couldn't like, get any closer to my sweet spot ever unless touching it.
Yeah. She knows
what am I gonna do?
She's a
at
pro.
Least, at least she doesn't know that I did.
She's a pro. She knows where to stop.
You know?
Yeah, that's where guys
but
don't
see,
really
my
have
dumb
that.
Ass looking over at his butt. I'm like, oh well, he just was looking at my tits. That's what I thought. And then he's like, oh, I didn't look at you once. I'm like.
I didn't mean it like that.
From that
right,
old
okay,
Mexican
first of all, let me just say this.
She's laughing at you. You got a booter from that old Mexican lady touching you. And right, first,
oh, yeah. Right, oh, no. Right. It took like 30 minutes of me bagging on his ass about it. And then I was like, well, I kind of got a little.
Well, when they're doing your back, you're laying down on one of those little sausage pillow things.
Yeah.
And then when you flip over, they cover your eyes with a
yeah.
towel. So
yeah.
you can't see anything anyway.
I know
so
what you're
took
saying.
The towel off.
They never took the towel off of me.
Oh,
I had the I had the no.
Oh,
I mean, when I had to sit up.
So you're
yeah.
looking over him, but you never looked at his face. You're just looking at his
body. I wasn't looking at his face. I was looking at his body. Yeah. If I would have looked at his face, I would have like completely turned to see his face.
Yeah,
we were
so.
Like side by side. So I could see, yeah, it was his fucking boner.
But to be honest
and
with
now,
you.
Wait, hang on. I think I got a theory here.
Yeah?
Okay.
I think you guys roll over. She's looking over. And now she can't see anything but your body because mm-hmm. the lady's covering maybe, you know, she's standing there rubbing. Mm-hmm. And she looks over and sees you're getting a boner. Next thing she knows, she's getting the thigh rub, and she sees your boner. She's like, he is... My husband still gets a boner just from seeing my tits. Fuck yeah, I got this going on.
Yep.
That's when you start thinking, ah.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why you were all, this feels great.
That sounds way better. Yes.
Boom.
Yes, let's go with that. Yep. 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 I'm going to go with that from
Plus,
here on
she
out.
Was rubbing just the right way.
I'm going with your story.
You had the mental fantasy. Plus, you had the physical action.
Yeah.
Boom.
Yes.
Boom, boner.
Now,
boom, no happy endings.
So is this boom,
no
boner, we got to go bang this out?
I wish.
Or do you guys walk away going,
we had kids.
That was weird.
No, we had kids.
We had kids. No, it was very much so.
Dad, take me snorkeling.
Yep. We walked out and they were right there.
Boom.
Hey, how was it, family? Great. Go the fuck away.
Then you get in the water and the ocean is, or the
motion.
You know, the motion of the ocean keeps hitting you in the crotch. Because you're in that shallow end because you're with your kid.
Yeah.
And so the water just keeps hitting you in the balls and in the dick. And then next thing you know, you're still thinking about what you're thinking earlier. And you're like, that's great, babe. Yeah, get another seashell. Do not get a boner. Do not get a boner. Do not get a boner.
I seriously was waiting for at least one, like, massage, you know, stomach thing. And then just a little... You know, just
oh
a little,
my God. Let's,
just a little, one little rundown
let's,
just to
let's
let
do
me
a
know.
You really thought that would happen?
Well, and I also thought, you know, I also thought, like, I was like, this woman, like, if I don't get a boner, like, she's going to be disappointed in herself,
of course.
I would think.
She's working for the boner.
Right.
Oh, my God.
Right. That's exactly what's going on. So I've got like three personalities going on in my head. One of them's talking me out of a boner. One of them's like, no, you have to have a boner. The other one's being like,
dude, you
count to 20 and forget you ever thought of the word boner.
You know Lolita and Quinta walked in there
Lolita.
Going, I bet I can get this man off in 2 minutes. She's like, oh, I bet I can get her off before you can get him off.
I got 20 pesos.
Oh,
20 pesos.
On. Hola. Hello.
Nobody got off.
Exactly.
No. No.
You guys didn't tip well, did you?
Mm-mm.
You spent all your money on those robes.
Seven USD.
Yeah.
So
experience.
Outside of that,
I
though,
vote do it.
Yeah.
At least
I mean,
once.
Anytime you want to get a fucking facial, man, let me know.
Let me tell you one thing. You guys are a little unique.
You think?
I can honestly tell you that if I was sitting here with my wife and she goes, I looked over and saw you had a boner, I don't think I'd come home for that vacation.
Oh, stop.
Because she wasn't sitting there going, he's got a boner for my tits. No.
That's where my brain went. Danny, I didn't look at you at all. And I was like, oh, damn.
I couldn't.
Okay.
I was blindfolded the entire time.
Well, that's fine.
It got awkward.
I get it.
When
I get it.
It got awkward when I saw you grab the masseuse's hand and put it on your dick. I was a little alarmed by that, but what did I care? I had a stone up my ass.
No, I followed suit and I grabbed my massage therapist's hand.
Just flick it a little bit.
Take that hot stone, put it up my other crack.
Hey, holla.
See
right?
How this goes.
I really think it would have rather have been in the front than the back. I'm not going to lie.
Wow.
Well,
okay.
Just saying.
Just put my
I'm not an ass
just,
chick.
Just set my iPhone on top of it and call me 5 times.
Wow.
Sure.
Wow. Okay. Yeah, I mean, but yeah, we walked out of it and there were immediate kids and dinner plans and all kinds of other shit.
That's the worst. You go get relaxed and and even if it wasn't erotic, like,
because
it does, I feel like if you do something relaxing like that, and erotic tensions get built up, I'm worse off than I was when I went in.
Right.
Because now I got to release more tension.
Right.
I kind of need the guy to massage me, so there is no, like, boner.
Yeah, but what
right?
if? What if?
What if?
Well, what if?
I guess I'll
oh, my God.
I'll deal with that afterwards.
Oh, my God.
See?
What
See?
The fuck? That, I'm so glad it wasn't a guy, because if I walked away from there... boner qualified.
I would have been
so
pissed
like,
if you had the dude and I had the
really
chick.
Need to rethink.
Yeah, but think about how happy you would have been to see your daughter when she walked up like, Daddy, you'd be like, yep, let's go to the beach. Fuck yeah.
I made you. You're the woman.
I feel much more relaxed
with
now.
Much more masculine.
Much more relaxed being with my kids. This is so much better.
Oh, Lord. It was an experience. That's
That last section was brought to you by SarahShonertMusic.com. Sarah with an H, S-C-H-O-N-E-R-T. ShonertMusic.com. Check her out. This is her her new song that is available on iTunes.
Sweet.
So check her out.
Buy it.
Go to our Facebook page. We got a link straight to it. So
great.
Leave her a comment, too. Review it.
Yeah. Yeah, let her know what you think.
Get her get her some boost. Let her know the William Barron Show is there helping support some local music.
Yes.
Especially.
Yeah. Local music, for sure. We are going to take a break. Thank you guys for listening to the William Barron Show. We'll be right back after this.
Orange column of light, reaching just short of dawn. I'll admit it's beautiful. Lovely warning.
Lovely warning
of the storm that's blowing. On the edge of today, this person you think you know, far cry from who I am. I'll admit it's partly true. I'm a function of a chain reaction of reconcilings. Recognize this for what it is and understand that it will implode in joy that's floating your hands, but know that you'll have to let it go.
Don't think I didn't love.
Don't think I didn't love every minute of it. Don't think I didn't love every minute of it. Don't think I didn't love every minute of it. Don't think I didn't love. Don't think I didn't love. Don't think I didn't love.
Welcome back to the William Barron Show. This portion of the podcast is brought to you by Sarah Schonert, music.com. Sarah with an H, S-C-H-O-N-E-R-T. Check her out on iTunes. Check her out on our Facebook page. Check her out on our website. She is everywhere. So, when are we getting our manicures, Joe?
I'll take a manicure. What I really want is the pedicure. I really want
pedicure.
I want my feet to be taken care of.
They don't do a whole lot for your manicures.
Yeah.
Manicure's like $12.
Yeah, but what do you want your feet?
A pedi's like $25.
Yeah, but when I walk away, I want my...
They rub all the way to your kneecap.
I want my
they
nails to be all glossy.
Calf, and then your whole... Like your foot, putting a sock on your foot is like...
I don't want them to touch my hands. I want to be drinking that beer.
Yeah, they do serve liquor.
Yeah, they hand you Bartles and James.
Yeah, I drink champagne. Every time I go, I drink champagne the whole time.
Sure.
It's great.
Okay.
I mean, it's like
you and I don't
cheap shit, but
you and I don't like champagne, but say we bring in a
fifth
of Jaeger.
They have beer.
Who cares?
Yeah, dude. I was just thinking the other day that I went to a
nothing more manly than getting a pedicure with a Jaeger bomb.
Listen, Yoki, can
you
mind if I take a piss?
Not more manly.
Is that
like right here on you?
Can I just be in my tub? My little foot spa.
We have very established. These seats can absorb human pee. You may pee. Go.
We sterilize.
Free yourself.
Sorry. I do a terrible Israeli accent.
Honey, they're usually Chinese, not Israeli.
I know. I was trying to cover my racist slur.
Okay.
You just
broke
his... I don't
think Islamic women are allowed to touch feet or something. I don't know.
Is that true? You think
feet?
So?
I don't blame them. I don't want to touch somebody's feet.
Know.
Is that because Jesus touched feet and they said, fuck that?
Yep. That's exactly
nobody touched feet.
That's exactly where my statistics
feet are
just
evil.
Came from.
They make you walk away.
However, I do believe the Chinese, Vietnamese, that whole culture worships feet.
Okay.
I think they do. I think they think pretty feet makes a good person.
You guys
pretty feet, pretty life.
You guys ever... the whole foot fetish porn where
I don't
fuck?
Get that foot jobs
where the guy sucks on foot the toes
jobs?
Foot jobs
foot job like
Joe will you
finger
will you
somebody
explain,
with a foot
will you explain to her what a foot job is
instead of a blow job it's
or
a foot
hand
job
it's your feet yeah
nothing grosses me out more
how does that work
The guy just sucks on toes.
No. A foot job is where a guy has... And the girl uses her feet.
You're
and she like bends her legs like this to where the palms of her feet are like going up and down.
So instead of instead of using two hands like in a praying motion over her dick...
Your foot with an arch.
She pushes her two arches together and does that.
Yeah. And it's huge.
How delicate could that be?
How could that ever work?
You're getting a heel in the balls at least twice.
No, that's not going to work. What's the purpose?
I don't know. Because weird fucking dudes, sorry if you're out there.
Sorry, like, listeners, if you're one of them.
Like feet. Feet, to me, is the most disgusting part of any person's body.
Yep. Yeah.
I would rather sit there and have an ass job, all right?
Than a foot job.
Fuck my asshole and fucking prick my dick with your feet.
I would rather have the, you know... I think it's more erotic to have her bend her foot back and fuck the crease behind her knee or something. I mean,
fuck her calf and thigh leg.
Yeah.
Titty fuck. That's another one. Titty fuck.
Armpit job. Fuck
yeah,
it.
Armpit job.
What?
Whoa.
I'll take that over a foot job.
Over
I'm
a
just
foot
saying.
Job,
there's
sure.
such thing as an armpit
job? No, I've never
oh,
seen an
I'm
armpit
sure,
job, but I'm sure it's out
is,
there.
Yeah.
Just I think we have Google to look it.
It
up now.
Google it.
Yeah,
we,
look it up.
We might have to
I don't need
it
to Google
later.
It. I don't want to see that.
I kind
of
do.
Because it's probably going to be a guy shoving his dick into a hairy armpit of some French woman, like, and she's not even speaking English.
Why
and
would
just
it be
being
hairy?
Like, because French women don't shave.
But why does it have to be hairy?
Because they don't shave.
Why does it have to be a French one?
Because French women don't shave.
Yeah, French women don't shave.
Oh, my God.
They don't shave their legs.
Okay, so is it only French people that give armpit fucks?
I would assume.
Oh,
I would
my
think.
God. You're making that up.
They also
I'm
don't
not,
bathe.
I'm not, yeah, and they don't, they don't
no
bathe
idea.
That often.
I know. But whatever.
I would
it's
just imagine that
it's
if
fine.
There was an
but
armpit
they don't like
job.
Patchouli. I mean, they're not even hippies.
Patchouli.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. I don't
know. Speaking of all
that shit's weird.
Sex talk.
Yeah, titty fucking, I don't get that either. Probably because I don't have big boobs. That's probably why we don't get it.
Yeah.
So, with all the
sex talk.
Sex talk, you know, everything's about sex.
Welcome back to the William Barron Sex Show. Joseph, you were saying?
Sex talk with Joseph.
So,
William.
I'm watching the news tonight. Not the local news, the world news.
Yeah.
And you know how there's always commercials for pharmaceuticals?
Viagra.
All you see is Viagra, Cialis,
sure.
Or like.
Get it,
got the shekels? And so.
Shingles? Do you mean shingles?
Today, I meant shingles. I said shekels.
I
could
so, do a shekel, but I don't know what a shingle.
So I'm watching the news today, and they got a new Viagra commercial out. But this isn't Viagra for men. It's for women.
What?
If you have gone through menopause and sex hurts vaginally.
By KY.
No, but lube doesn't
don't
do this. No. There's a drug you take, right?
What?
Now, here's the thing about the situation. Viagra.
As a whole.
No. Viagra, Cialis.
May
all,
make your erection last longer than
all
hours.
These commercials. How do these commercials go? You guys know how they go.
Oh, yeah.
There's...
Handsome middle-aged,
handsome older man
with his
super
handsome
sexy wife.
Younger
yeah.
wife,
right?
And they're walking hand in hand, and they're
she's half naked, he's fully clothed. I know
they're just having a nice day,
mm-hmm.
playing,
and then
tennis.
They maybe smile at each other like, mm-hmm. "I think mm-hmm. we might fuck tonight."
There's a bench usually somewhere in these commercials,
and who do you think they're trying to sell that to? They're trying to sell it to you, girls.
Oh.
They're trying to sell Viagra to you,
because
if you take if you get your guy to take Viagra, okay. now you're having a romantic day again, just like you did when you were first dating.
Fucking 30.
Now, who do you think they're trying Four to sell kids. This lady Viagra to?
The men?
Nope. They're trying to sell it to the ladies again. But this time...
Women buy shit. It's true.
This time, this is... We're talking 60-year-old women.
Ew.
Now, very, very attractive
60-year-old woman.
But 60-year-olds nonetheless, because the face doesn't lie. The weather's there, right?
Oh,
the weather is
there. They're in nightgowns, and they're lying in the bed, and they're rolling over with their hair slipping Mm-mm. around, Mm-mm. and they're just sly smiling, like,
they're bun now.
And there's not one man in any shot.
Oh,
it's all just a woman by herself, like, buy blah, 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 because you'll never know what it's like. And it's just a constant, like, oh, my God, these old women want to have sex.
Viagra vagina also causes massive internal bleeding, shortness of breath.
Heart attack, heart disease, diarrhea, gonorrhea.
It's
vomiting.
It's called Viginra.
Vagina.
It has a new disease.
Vagina. No, it's not a disease. 60. That's the name of the pill.
No, that's the name of the pill. Take
not Viagra. Vagina.
It sounds like a disease.
Viginra.
Viginra.
And they even say...
Is it really called Viginra?
No.
You just made that up, didn't
No,
you?
I made that up.
I love it. I love it.
But they actually say in the commercial, because...
no woman would buy something called Viginra.
They say... Because personal lubricants can't do this.
Ooh.
Whatever. False.
That's what they say.
I mean,
you say false.
Clearly, I haven't hit menopause. I hope I'm like good 30 years from it, but...
False. KY is my
False.
Breakfast cereal.
I just don't know how it wouldn't.
I don't know. I think the idea of vagina is
it
stimulates
I mean,
you from the inside out.
I know
out.
What it feels like.
According
and I
don't
know
to
how
the commercial.
It solve the problem.
Well, here's the thing.
I
though.
Get it with a dude. You have to get it up.
But think about this. As a dude taking Cialis, the whole point of it is you can't get it up without a pill.
Yeah.
Viagra, you take the pill, you got an instant boner.
Sure.
Cialis, you take the pill, and you can get a boner whenever you want within within
8 hours, I believe.
The 8 hours, right?
Right.
Now, if you're a lady, and the moment hits you, and you guys are getting it on, hang on, let me lube up, because you're fucking some young guy. Do you really want to take the second to roll over, grab the lube, and I'm ready? And he's like... Yeah, I put on a condom
you know
for this.
What?
No.
You know what? Never mind.
I would be like, you know, I'm old.
So now you can be moist for the next 8 hours.
Oh, okay.
You're ready. Just like some guy would want to be.
I can't comment on that. I'm not old enough.
All right, truckers.
Check
trucker
me back.
Ladies.
Ladies
let
and
us
gentlemen,
know.
Check me back in 30 years. I hope we're still doing the podcast, and I can let you know all about it.
Plus, you don't want some guy going down on... The dry biscuit.
I
would imagine that his saliva would.
I don't want I was going to say that, but I don't want to cross the line with my husband tonight.
Can I get some ricotta on the
biscuit? That's what he's worth. I mean, that's your fucking job when you go there, yo.
All right.
Yeah, but when you're that old, when you're old, I guess you don't get moist.
I don't know.
You need a little help.
I don't.
Mother Nature.
Moist.
I have no idea.
The guy doesn't have that much spit in his mouth.
Moist.
Oh, my God.
Moist. Thank you for listening to the William Barron Show, Danielle.
Oh,
thank you for being here tonight.
Yes, thank you. Sorry
Joseph.
It was dirty tonight, boys and girls.
Joseph.
Sorry for the crash show.
Craig Ketchum, we miss you. This podcast was brought to you by Exkooz Yourself Koozies. Check them out. They've got good stuff. We're going to throw some pictures up on our Facebook page. Sarah Schonert, music.com. Sarah with an H, S-C-H-O-N-E-R-T, music.com. Check them both out on our Facebook page. Joe, what's your thoughts on Wix.com?
Winx?
Wix, W-I-X.
Well, I can tell you a little something about Wix.com. Wix.com will get you web presence, and it'll take your world to higher levels. You go out there, yeah, Facebook is great, Twitter's great. Where do those people go if
you
they want to find out more streaming content from you?
You need a professional website.
Do you want a blog? Do you want a business?
Do you want to sell stuff from
you
your website?
Do you want a store?
With PayPal.
What do you
want to
do?
I mean, everything.
They'll do it all with you. They will work with you. You go there. It's self-explanatory. They got the great, great support 24/7. You go there, they'll set up your website.
365.
Whatever you want to do on the web, these guys can help you get it done.
I'm sure I've already told you that Sarah Schoner, she's gone through Wix. Her website is done by Wix.
Yeah.
I mean,
it looks great.
It looks great. I mean, we checked it out, so. Anyway, that's Wix.com. Check them out. Go to our website, blackballoonstudio.com. Go all the way to the bottom. Click on the link to help us out a little bit. Thank you guys for listening to this extremely X-rated podcast tonight.
If you're still here.
If you haven't tuned out yet.
We will see you next week. Thanks for listening.
I am confronting my most painful regret. Hear the thoughts poured out, my fight not yours. Please forgive me. Hope for a Monday and a Tuesday distraction. Try this again on Wednesday, then recheck our reaction. I'm sorry for anything that I said, getting too deep inside my head. Let's start this over. Let's start this over. Let's start this over. Against all the odds, against me.